The Apostle Peter said, beloved, in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 12, beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened to you. And Peter was aware that by the Holy Spirit, a warning was coming to the Christian population of that generation, that a great persecution was about to arise against them. 1989, I came home from an evangelistic crusade in Eastern Canada, where I'm telling other people about the goodness of God. I'm telling others about the blessing. I'm telling them about the provision. I'm telling them about the protection of God. Came home from that season of traveling to the total loss of the physical structure of our home. Fire department said it was one of the most incredible fires they'd ever seen. The house was completely burned. There was nothing left, not a single wall standing. Everything fell into the foundation. An absolute, complete, and total destruction of my home. Came back from an evangelistic crusade. I remember standing in my yard and the memories suddenly were flooding me. The comforts, the pictures, everything was gone. I had labored hard to rebuild what was an old log farmhouse into something that was a little more modern. All the memories are gone. All of our pictures of our children, our family, everything that we'd accumulated up to that point in 1989 was gone. It was complete and total destruction of everything that we owned. The songs of praise that were sung in that house. This was a house where praise was. We had an old piano in the living room. And during one season, there were many, many people who gathered there together. And I remember the songs we used to sing, the glory, the joy of the Lord that used to be in that house. Many people were taken into shelter there. One winter, we had 17 people in our home. A single mother and two children whose husband had died. Another who was in a difficult situation. A pastor that needed shelter to continue the work of God and others in that home. I looked at what used to be the kitchen where Pastor Teresa and I were called into the ministry and where the Holy Spirit met me in a sovereign way, a way that I have cried out to God for many years that He would do that again. So suddenly, so fearful, I'd never, ever even anticipated that God could meet a person like that. Suffice to say, it was an encounter with God that brought a deeper fear into my heart than anything I'd ever known in my lifetime. But yet there was a strange comfort with it. I can't explain it to you other than that way. It was in this house on the steps that led up to the living room that I wrote the song, I Love You, Jesus. Sat there with my guitar one day, newly saved, filled with the Holy Spirit, absolutely in love with God. The provision of God all around, the protection of God, the blessing of God was touching my home on every side. The faith of God was coming into my heart to trust Him for the impossible. In that house, we not only fed people, but we were fed supernaturally. Many of you know the story of how the Lord provided. It's the house that we were returning to after having spoken of the goodness of God to so many people, to find everything materially and physically altered. There was only one thing left standing of my house. It was the fireplace and its chimney. And it was still standing because it had been built and designed and equipped to stand in the fire. It stood there as an ominous reminder that one day everything that can be shaken is going to be shaken, that only that which cannot be shaken might remain. Let me read it to you, please, from Hebrews chapter 12. I'll just read it to you for time's sake. Whose voice then shook the earth, but now He's promised, saying, yet once more, I shake not the earth only, but also heaven. And this word, yet once more, signifying the removing of those things that are shaken as of things that are made. Or in other words, the things that can be shaken have been made by another source than by the hand of God. That those things which cannot be shaken may remain. Wherefore, we receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace whereby we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. For our God is a consuming fire. You know, one day we get to heaven, the scripture says that every man's work will be tried by fire to prove what kind of a work it really is. And I do believe that down here on this earth, and perhaps in our generation, much of what calls itself the house of God is about to be tested by fire to see whether or not it really is the house of God. Paul said in Ephesians 6, 12 and 13, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Paul says, take the whole armor of God. Now, later in Ephesians, he begins to explain, having your loins girded with truth, having the helmet of salvation on, the sword of the Spirit, shield of faith, your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Talks about the totality of believing God, of having received the kingdom of God and the word of God, and having embraced the commission of God. Paul knew from his own experience that half-hearted, lukewarm approach as to the things of God will not get you through, folks. You won't get through and I won't get through. And having done all, he said, to stand. Now this structure that withstood the fire and destruction of what I had once called home was not made of just ordinary material. It was made of previously tested and proven substance. Actually, fireplace mortar, I don't know how many of you know this, but it actually gets stronger the more the heat touches it. Ordinary mortar used in the fireplace will begin to crumble. It will crack, it will dry out, but there's a special ingredient that God puts in the mortar that's in a fireplace that when the fire touches it, it gets stronger. The evidence of the true Christian life is that no matter what God brings against, what God allows rather to be brought against us, no matter what the enemy throws our way, if Christ is in us, if the right mixture of God's life as it is in us, we become stronger by the fire. We become deeper by the testings that are all around us.